The aim of the experiment is to design a crystal oscillator for operating frequency of which produces an oscillation of 4 MHz. The circuit diagram is as shown in the figure. R1 and R2 are the voltage divider circuit. Here, instead of a tank circuit, you are using 4.43 MHz crystal oscillator in series with 0.01 microfarad. And to the base, you have SL100. Okay, to the collector, we have an RC resistor which in turn is connected to VCC of 10 volts. Across the emitter bias, we have 1K pot variable resistor, and next we are connecting it in series with RE resistance of 220 ohm, which is in parallel with 47 microfarad pot.
Today, modern electronics makes use of this crystal oscillator. In every electronic circuits today, wherever your frequency has been generated, we are making use of this circuits. Crystal oscillators. Using crystal oscillator, we are generating frequencies. Crystal oscillator. The important components you require is RE and RC and R1 and R2. To find RE, we will be getting 200 ohms. VE is given by VCC by 10, which gives you 1 volt. RE is given by VE by IE, which is equal to 200 ohms. So RE is equal to 220 ohms. To find RC, VCC is given by VCC by 2, which is 5 volts. You apply Kirchhoff voltage law for the CE loops. So you will be getting RC is equal to 800 ohms to 820 ohms approximately. To find R1, assume VBE is equal to 0.7 volt because this is the cut-in voltage of the diode. So VBE is given by VBE minus VE, which is equal to. So R1 is given by VCC minus VB divided by 10 kV, which is equal to 16.6 kΩ, approximately equal to 18 kΩ. To find R2, you have to assume 9 IB through R2. R2 is given by VB divided by 9 IB, which is equal to 1.7 divided by 9 into IB is given by 0.05 milliamperes. You use 3.3 kΩ. So you require coupling capacitors, where coupling capacitors have used 0.01 microfarad and 0.47 microfarad. Here 0.01 microfarad, another one is 0.47 microfarad, and emitter bypass capacitor is given by 47 microfarad. So we have designed it a crystal oscillator that's not equal to 4 MHz. In this circuit diagram, R1 and R2 are the voltage divider circuit. R1 is equal to 18 kΩ, R2 is equal to 3.3 kΩ from the design, and you have a crystal which is working for 4.43 MHz. With that, you have a capacitor of 0.01 microfarad, and RC is the resistance connected across the transistor. RC is given by 820 ohms. This is in turn connected to VCC is equal to 10 volts. You have an emitter bias where you have 1K pot. It is interconnected in series with 220 RE resistance in parallel with your 47 microfarad capacitor.
So it is the circuit which rig up already. So this is the transistor SL100. So you can see SL100, and the terminals are emitter, base and collector. Okay, you can see emitter, base and collector, and this is the crystal which we are going to use for the oscillations here. So first the base thing, base. So here the base pin is connected across here. So 18 kilo ohm resistor and 3.3K resistors are the voltage divider circuit, voltage divider resistors connected, and 1820 ohms is connected to collector, and this crystal is connected in series with the base to collector. So here 0.01, so this capacitor and this crystal is connected here. So from base to one end the capacitor is connected, and from capacitor the crystal is connected to collector of the transistor. So after that, so emitter pin, so in this the emitter is this one. So across the emitter you can see 1 kilo ohm pot, so is series connected, and 220 ohm and 47 kilo ohm kilo microfarad, so 220 ohms and 47 microfarad capacitor is parallelly connected across pot and to the ground, and same thing 3.3k, this both 3.3k as well as this circuit is connected to ground, and in this circuit this is the ground point where I am connecting this ground to the supply source of negative, and positive is connected to VCC across here where R1 and RC are connected. R1 18 kilo ohms and RC is connected to regulated DC power supply, and we are given here 12 volts. So after these connections we can see the output what we are getting here. So this is the sinusoidal signal. So from peak to peak you have to measure from, or you can take one full cycle. So I will vary my exposition such that I can see the full waveform what I am getting. So from here you can see, so from one full cycle is approximately around 0.5, I am getting 0.5 here. So let me write down. One cycle I am getting 0.5 divisions, in this I am getting 0.5 division into the time. So you can see the time here, it is 0.5 microseconds. So into 0.5 micro, which means 10 to the power of minus 6 seconds. So this is the T. So F is equal to 1 by T. So I will do divided by 0.5 into 0.5 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So I am getting F is equal to 4 into 10 to the power of 6, which means 4 mega, and the unit of F is hertz. So practically also I am getting same 4 megahertz. Okay, so this completes the crystal oscillator circuit. Thank you.